this tutorial is obviously inspired by peacock feathers because I like peacock feathers. I mean, I have earrings. People who saw my shopping haul a while back probably remember, maybe remember. I actually bought these feathers for this look, these three. I actually planned on chopping those up for this look, but then I encountered some really tiny without the whole eye thing, smaller peacock feathers, and then I ended up cutting those up for this look and sticking these in my hair. And then these behind me are actually from a peacock from the local petting zoo years ago. Anyway, I like peacock feathers as decorational material, and obviously on the birds they're also very pretty. But I thought, why not stick them on my eye also? That seemed also like a good idea. So yeah, pretty much I decided to do two different eyes because I like it when things are asymmetrical. But also if you think this is just this is probably too much for a casual look. But if you just want to do a sort of more wearable look, you could just do this eye, which is also vaguely inspired by the feathers. And this one is full on peacock eye. So yeah, let's get started.
So, unsurprisingly, I, as usual, started with the Maybelline Contour Tool in Crème de Rose. And on both my eyes, I applied it all the way from the lash line to the eyebrow. As you can see here. And on the eye where I'm going to put all the peacock feathers, I'm also going to put it underneath the eye. Because I want it to be big and colorful and smoky, so yep. Then for most of the colors, I use the Urban Decay Electric Palette. Which, as you can see, has a lot of colors. And I'll put all the names of the colors I use down below in the description box, by the way, as usual. But yeah, I started out with this silver one on the eye that isn't going to have feathers on it. So like the normal, regular eye, I guess. And I pretty much just packed it on the eyelid. It's really, really nice and glittery. Then I used the blue shade. I think this one is called Chaos. Anyway, I use that in the crease. And I try to keep it sort of close to the most inner part of the crease. I also put it on the outer V. As you can see, it's a little bit paler where it goes over the silver, but once blended, it sort of just looks like shininess rather than, completely different color. Anyway, then I use a very small sponge, a very small brush. And a dark green shade. And sort of went over the part where the blue was blended onto my skin. That's why I didn't want to make the blue too big. It's because this was also going there still. And then I used a fluffy blending brush to just blend it all out. All the way around the eye. And then for my eyebrow on that side, I used the darkest shade from this Essence palette. This specific one is an eyebrow set from a really old autumn collection, but it's the same, exactly the same product as their regular eyebrow stuff is, so yeah. That's pretty much the same. Then for my other eye, I also used the same palette. And I started out with a blue shade that I pointed to off screen. It's the same blue shade that I used on the other eye in the crease. And if you don't have this palette, of course, you could just use, the same color from another brand. But yeah, what I did was just pack it on. And then I actually used the same brush to sort of blend it into the crease a little. Which is just going to make it easier to blend the green onto it later on. The more blending you do between steps, the less blending you have to do at the end. And I also applied it with a rather large brush, at least. Larger than I usually use underneath my eye. Applied it underneath my eye. And then I again went to the green shade with the same brush. And did pretty much the same as on the other eye, only with this eye kept it more tight, I guess. I blended it less. But I just encircled the blue with the green. And I did it all around the eye. Obviously, underneath the eye, I did use a smaller brush. I wanted it to be mainly to the top and not all that much in the bottom. I wanted it to be more smoked out than I usually would do it. But not too much, I guess. And I also randomly decided to sort of drag it down in a point in the inner corner. But yeah, we did the blue and now it's up to the sort of brownish thing. Wanted to use the dark one first, then decided to go for the paler one randomly. Anyway, this is also an eyebrow powder. It's less pigmented, of course, than the pressed pigments. from Urban Decay, because they're pressed pigments. But yeah, I just applied it all around my eye. This took actually longer than the rest, because I really had to layer it before it was opaque enough, in my opinion. But it worked, and then I went to this lime green shade. And yeah, if your eyebrows are darker than mine, then they will show up more than mine did. But it doesn't really matter all that much. I'm just putting the green there in case there will be a little bit of eyebrow visible through the feathers. Because there's going to be a feather on top of it anyway. And other than that, I just encircled the brown with the green. Also, underneath my eye, I pretty much just did exactly as a peacock feather looks. And then it looks like that. It looks really weird before the feathers are on there, actually. But yeah, anyway, then I just highlighted the green with a little bit of paler green from the Urban Decay palette. And I did the same with the blue. Highlighted it with blue, not green. And then I grabbed the blending brush again and mainly blended the outer sides, like the outer edge of the color spot thing. And then I lined my waterlines with an eyeshadow pencil by Isochet. It's called Bleu Nuit. Bleu Nuit. Something French. Anyway, dark blue just seemed like a suitable color for this. And then I used mascara, the Scandalized Ligaflex mascara from Rimmel. And I applied it on both my top and lower lashes, but my camera didn't record it. So, yeah. Onto the feathers. So, these are actually smaller feathers. I cut the tip of this one. They're not like the feathers with the whole, like, circle on it. These are smaller ones. I think I got them off a craft store, but I'm not sure. But yeah, don't put the liquid nail art tape. Normal liquid latex. I do nail art videos too often. Anyway, don't put it on your eyebrow. Like, this stuff can be removed with water, a little bit of oil, makeup remover, stuff like that. But still, it's just, it makes life easier to not put it on your eyebrows, because it's less of an effort to remove it when it's just on skin. But yeah, just made a little dot and stuffed the feather on there. And then just apply some more on top of there. And decided I did want them to stick out to the top and not to the side. So I put some more liquid latex there. And just pretty much took all the hair of the feathers. I'm not sure what to call it. But yeah, just took it all in the direction that I want it to be. Which can be quite challenging with very long nails, I can tell you. But it worked out in the end. And then for the rest of the feathers around the eye, I just pretty much cut the hair of the feather strips, whatever they're called. But yeah, just put some liquid latex underneath my eye and then put them on there one by one. And then I also put some, yeah, just around the rest of my eye. It's really just up to, like, where you want the feathers to be. Like, I pretty much just, like, I didn't have a straight idea of where I wanted them. I just, you know, decided to put one there and there and there. And, yeah. I just continued to add them until it looked good, in my opinion. And then it looked like this. Then it's time for the rest of the face. I used blush for both blush and contouring, actually, this time. It's a nude blush by Essence called Autumn Peach, and with the liquid latex, you can just carefully apply it on your other cheek as well. If you're careful, then the feather should just stay in place. Then I used the silver shade from the eyeshadow palette as a highlighter. Don't apply too much, because as you can see here, it goes sort of grey. And I had to spend an age blending it before it looked normal again. Then I also applied it on my nose and on my chin, and also on my cupid's bow. And then I used this lipstick. This is Rosewood Pearl by Maybelline. Decided to go for the nude lips this time. I don't often do that, but yeah, I just really wanted the focus to be on the eyes. And that's the final part of the look. You can see the results. And yeah, I actually really like it. Like, it's obviously nothing for normal wear. But I do really like it. I hope you enjoyed watching this. Thank you very much for watching. And see you next time. Bye! And then just make sort of a baby wing. Just a really tiny wing. And then just filled in.